Good morning, everybody. It is August 30th, and we are back in the shop for another great week of work. I got a few things I want to go over before we get started into actual working. First thing is, if you just know who Steel Stamps Inc. is, I'm not sure if you know. I know someone's known from Don Gonzales. He gets his maker stamps off of them. But I was talking to Tim Purdy from Steel Stamps Inc. back in Waco, and I kind of going over, I wanted a smaller maker stamp. I had a crappy brass one. I mean, it wasn't bad, but I was really going towards a steel stamp. Well, I talked to him, got a order in down in Waco, and it showed up Friday, I believe. Whoo, check that out. It is a one-piece steel stamp. This thing is absolutely amazing. I mean, this thing is super, super nice. I got it, you get it, as you can see here. Excuse me, but I have been just playing around this stamp all day long. Oh, dropped that one, but but yeah, I absolutely love this stamp. I will be going and buying more off of him. Instead of having a brass stamp, I'm gonna buy another steel stamp. I'm gonna get one for saddles and then just one bigger regular size steel stamp. Another question I had was what size needles I use in my patching machine. So I'm guessing I use these size 18 needles. You can buy these from BAM Saddle Tech as well. I'm guessing this is the size needle I use because it's the only open pack of needles that I have. hope that answers your question. They have a list on the Patcher website, or not Patcher, but BAM's website, of all the needle sizes and what size thread to use with them too. So they have the whole chart there for you to check out if you're concerned like what size needle you use for what thread. It's all on there, so you don't have to worry about that. Someone else asked me about my bar grounders, or not bar grounders, my back grounders. So I do have a set of bar grounders and the matted background. The bar grounders, I don't ever use. My tooling for me is just too small. I got too big of a bar grounder, so it does not fit my background. Sometimes I will use it. I'll use it on some of my flowers and all. I won't use it as a backgrounder, but I actually use it in my tooling to kind of give some stems and stuff different looks. I do have a custom set coming from FK Russell. I talked to him back in Waco too at the Heart of Texas Leather Show. I got like a flower center or two ordered off of him and a bar grounder set. I'm waiting for him to email me back about that and hopefully get them in here soon. I mainly use a matted background tool. So this is just literally a cheap $6 or $7 stamp from Tandy Leather. These are both the same ones. I just filed one down because if some of my background gets really, really small. So I need something really, really tiny to fit down in those holes. So that's what those are right there. As you can see that, they're just basic matted background tools from Tandy Leather. Nothing crazy. That's it. I'm trying to think what else anyone asked me about. I do know someone asked me about the maintenance for the Cobra, my Class 4 Cobra. I will get to that later down the road in this video, but just not right now. I got some stuff I gotta lay out in the shop. Other than that, that's pretty much anything different going on the shop right now. Like I said, got the steel stamp in. Super, super happy about that. It is definitely, go check them out if you're looking to get a maker stamp. Definitely worth every penny. But other than that, I don't think there's anything too crazy. Let me check my little list right here I got for all the stuff. Oh, let's see. Whenever the backgrounders, needle size. Okay, so yeah, we're gonna stop this for 1 second and go over to the patcher machine. Someone asked me about the patch machine, the walking foot, and how to keep it from marking up the leather. So I'm gonna go ahead and take this over here real quick, and I'm gonna show you how I did that. All right, the first thing that I did whenever I got this patch machine for this mod, I took a Dremel, and I just Dremeled out the center of this. So any standard patch machine, this walking foot here, it actually goes across right here, and just one solid piece all the way around. Well, what I did was Dremel that out. I just Dremeled these down a little bit as well. And then all I did was just slide heat shrink tubing over it. Line it up, trim it down, and there you have it. And that'll help keep it from marking your leather up a lot. That's pretty much all I did. really, really simple. It took me like a couple minutes to do, but like I said, it just really helps out keeping your project from getting tore up from these jaws. Cause they're pretty wicked. They will rip your leather up bad. So you don't want that. That's about it for the talking part. Like I said, I'm gonna get into the Cobra a little bit, my maintenance, my oiling, and all that stuff I do to it. But I'll wait for a little bit to do that down the week. Like I said, I usually typically record these Monday through Thursday. I'll put them Thursday and have them there for Friday morning. So I will get that this sometime this week. But like I said, right now I'm just going to get back to working on some Hey Dudes. I got 4 more pairs in the shop as of now. But I'm sure there's going to be more that comes in this week. So let's go ahead and start laying out a pair right now. I think it's going to be a sunflower pair. So get cracking on that. Watch my last video I just posted on YouTube. I ran out of veg tan leather. It happens. I wasn't paying attention to what I had. I thought I had another side, but I don't. So now what we're gonna do is I got a little bit left, so I've been making some of these front pocket wallets. I think it's like a 3-inch strip. A 3-inch wide strip. I stripped out like 2 of them. I think I was working on a tag there, something I never got to. So I do have that. So I have been making some front pocket wallets out of that. And we'll probably get to 1 or 2 of them in this video. I'm not too sure. We'll see where it goes. But since we are have a bunch of downtime, well, since I've had downtime, I got plenty of stuff I got done. I washed the truck, changed the oil, cleaned the shop up, got some other stuff done around the house. Yeah, but someone asked me in the last video about the maintenance I do on my Cobra. So we'll go ahead and we'll jump over to that and try to throw in some time here in this video, since you're not going to see a whole lot of tooling because I screwed up. So let's hop on over to that. Okie dokie, here's my somewhat sticker bombed Class 4 Cobra. Alright, for maintenance, first thing, like I said, I just real quickly just check through, make sure that the belt's not loose, but not too tight. And then all your oil points, pretty much, you'll see right here, this red paint. Alright, pretty much on every single oil point, just go ahead, just about every time you use it, for a drop of oil in there, you'll see them all over the place, back in there as well. Don't mind me, I'm dropping stuff everywhere. But yeah, so there is some stuff that you want to oil now and then. Like you gotta take this plate off, or you gotta take down in here, back in here, all that crazy stuff. Also, you also oil this too. Oil the front, oil the back, and also put a drop up in there. But yeah, I don't know the scientific terms you want to call it. But if you're really interested in like the whole nine yards and how to exactly oil it and do everything the professional way, go check out Al Bain's video on the Class 4 Cobra. He explains it very, very well and a lot better than me. I just go oil, bam, bam, bam. And yeah, so go ahead and check that video out if you're like I said, super keen on it. But that's pretty much how I just maintenance my Cobra. However, it is Thursday night, and I like to have these videos being uploaded on Friday, and unfortunately all day tomorrow. My mom just bought a house, so I will be helping her move all day tomorrow. I don't know how much more I'm gonna get on this video. I'm gonna try to work on some front pocket walls tonight. I'm literally just gonna add what I can in the video, and that's gonna be that. So we're gonna go ahead, jump into that, and start working on some front pocket walls.
She calls me day and night. I'm sorry, girl, you just don't make me feel right. I never meant to make you cry, you were right. Just leave me be, I'm not gonna put up a fight. Everything was good, then you would feel alive.
All right, as you can see, me and Lefty are ready for bed. It's 1 a.m. I still gotta edit this entire video and get this all wrapped up into one nice video for all of you. So I did have one more question on my YouTube that I noticed. Someone asked me what size lace I use and what kind. So I typically use 1/8 inch kangaroo lace. It's very rare they go bigger or smaller. 90% of the time, it's always an 1/8 inch kangaroo. But yeah, that's it for this video. Like I said, the wallet turned out pretty cool. I liked it. We didn't do any dye or paints, and it turned out pretty nice. Let me know what you think about this pattern. If you like it, you don't like it, whatever it is. And like I said, if you do like it and you just want to make some, I can make some actual floral pattern packs for it. Let me know if that's something you're interested in. So yeah, other than that, that's about it for the week. I'm going to jump off and get to editing. So I will see you all next week. I will try to post a video in between. I'm going to try my best, but like I said, the leather, as soon as it gets in, I'm about to get cracking at the orders. So I probably won't really get to that. So anyways, hope you all have a great weekend. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and I will see you next week.